students of class 5, welcome back to English Literature class. Today we will be learning poem Nature is What We See by Emily Dickinson. This will be our last class for second term syllabus. First of all, let us read the poem. Nature is what we see. Nature is what we see. The hill, the afternoon, squirrel, eclipse, the bumblebee, nay, nature is heaven. Nature is what we hear, the bobolink, the sea, thunder, the cricket, nay, nature is harmony. Nature is what we know, yet have no art to say. So helpless our wisdom is to our simplicity and in the case. Now let us see the word meaning. Nay. Nay means an old-fashioned, literary or dying word for no. Then, bumblebee. Bumblebee means a large, fuzzy, very heavy insect that is black and yellow color. Then, bobolink. Bobolink is a small black bird. Cricket. Cricket is an insect very close to the family of grasshoppers. Then we have helpless. Helpless means incapable of doing anything. Okay? In this poem, the reader can sense the poet Emily's sense of love and appreciation of nature. So, just by reading the poem, we can make out that the theme of the poem is nature's simplicity. So, what is the theme of the poem? The theme of the poem is nature's simplicity. The poem compares nature with the things we see, with the things we hear, and the things we know. So, the poem includes senses and is therefore divided into three parts, that means three stanzas. Okay? The first part, the first stanza, describes all the beauty of nature that we can see through our eyes. And the sight of nature mentioned in the poem are the hill, the afternoon, squirrel, eclipse, and the thunderbee. Okay? And in the second stanza describes all the wonderful sounds that nature has given us. So the sounds of nature mentioned in the poem are bobolink, the sea, thunder, and the cricket. Finally, the last stanza is about its importance to our mental well-being. Okay? Now, the last stanza here, the poet wants to emphasize that humanity lacks the ability to understand the power of nature. And humanity is not wise enough to define nature. Yet, nature is so simple. And here, we see that nature is heaven and nature is harmony. Here, the poet wants to say that spending time with nature is so peaceful and everything around us is so peaceful as well. So, students, I hope you enjoyed and understood the poem. Learn the poem by heart. It's only 12 lines, okay? So study hard and stay safe. Thank you.